Good afternoon.
Good
Hi. Y'all are so low energy today because it's the end of the day and you're tired. Now try it again. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Okay, so well, I'll take it. I'll take it. So this is eighth period and we are the 27th of February. No, like neck now. Put it away now. I have to be the center of attention. All right, you ready to go? All right, let's do this. So we're going to be talking about measuring angles inside of circles and then the arcs that these angles are creating. And so the first thing that we need to talk about is something called the central angle. The central angle of a circle is the angle where the vertex of the angle is in the center of the circle. And it creates an arc, okay? So if I look at this central angle, angle ABC, it is creating this arc from A to C along the circle. I name this arc, arc AC. The symbol's very ugly drawn, I'm sorry. Arc AC. And it's going to feel a lot like drawing the symbol for line segment, except that was a straight line. And since this is part of a circle, you're going to make it round. Okay? Arc AC. Now, if I asked you, how far is it in degrees to go all the way around the circle, what would you say?
360.
Which means if I were to take all of the central angles inside of a circle and add them all together, I should get
360.
So let's do one of these examples using that. Which one would you like, 10 or 11?
10.
You'll have to do 11 on your own. Okay, number 10. You just told me that if I add up all the central angles in a circle, I'm gonna get 360 degrees. So this angle plus this angle plus this angle plus this angle equal 360 degrees. And now I solve this for x, so what should I do? Huh? What should I do? Adam? Okay. So I'm going to add all of these up. All right, someone with a calculator, because that's too many numbers for my brain to add by itself. Please help.
Eight twenty.
280. Oh. My ears were dyslexic. Now what? Now what?
Subtract 280 from 360.
I can subtract 280 from both sides to get x by itself. And when I do that subtraction, x equals?
80.
80. Okay. Done. That's it. You can do number 11 on your own. Now, central angles do a lot more than just this. They end up creating a whole bunch of arcs in circles, and those arcs do a lot of different things. And so I have like a small paragraph checklist of all the things that arcs and central angles do. Central angle separates a circle into two arcs. It separates it into a major arc and a minor arc. The difference between them is that a major arc is going to be bigger than half the circle. And And a minor arc is going to be smaller than half the circle. That's the word circle. My C and my L crashed together and it looks like a D, and I'm sorry, but that's circle. All right, let's look at our circle here with some central angles drawn in it. And let's look at major arcs and minor arcs and have half of the circle. I have this arc from C to F. When you're drawing out the arcs, you're going to start at one letter. So if I do arc CF, start at the first letter, go toward the second letter, and take the shortest distance on the circle possible, because I'm lazy and I don't want to walk far. Okay? Shortest distance that you can. So arc CF would be this arc, not this one. Okay? Is this arc more or less than half the circle? Excuse me. Yes, it is less than half the circle. It's smaller than half the circle. This is a minor arc. I am so sorry. That's mine. Yeah, we're just going to, or we can just ignore it. It's fine. Sorry about that. Really loud. Sorry. Now, if I were to walk the other direction, if I were start at C and go to F, but instead of going the shortest distance, if I would walk this bigger distance, then the name, I can't name it CF. Because if I name it CF, like, which way did I go? Did I go the short way or the long way? And we're going to default to going the short way. So in order to make that difference, I am going to, bless you, start at C, bless you, and I'm going to write one of the letters in the direction that I want to go. I want to go this way toward H and G. You only need one of the letters, and you get to pick which one you like the best. I'm going to put H. So this arc, CHF, is a major arc because it goes the big way around the circle and is more than half the circle. This angle here, angle CEF, that's the central angle that's creating those two arcs. It's the angle where the vertex is in the center, and the arms, the rays of the angle, are intersecting the circle. And it cuts it in the short arc, and then it makes the major arc. Okay? The measure of a minor arc is less than 180 degrees because 180 degrees is half of a circle. And it's equal to the measure of its central angle. So if I said this central angle here, angle CEF, that measures 40 degrees, what would be the degree measure of this minor arc? If the minor arc is equal to the measure of the central angle that's making it, and this angle here measures 40, what is the measure of this minor arc? Also 40, because they're the same. Good. To get the measure of the major arc, all you have to do is take 360 and subtract whatever the minor arc is. So in this case, I had this minor arc measuring 40 degrees. How much would be this major arc? Well, 360 minus 40. Or in this case, 320? Double check it. Mm-hmm. Yeah, please. Notorious for being wrong about those things. 320? 360 minus 40?
Yeah, 320.
320? All right. Now, two arcs can be congruent. That arc can be congruent to this arc, and we're talking about this piece right here. Let me, that one, okay? So this arc, I'm saying, is congruent to this arc. And that happens only if the corresponding central angles making them are congruent. So in order for these two arcs to be congruent to each other, this angle here, 40 degrees, has to be the same measure as that angle. Okay. Assuming these arcs and angles are on the same circle. Or on circles that are the same size. Doesn't work if we're on different circles and different sizes. Okay. Not necessary. All right, ages ago, like beginning of the year. God, that was last year, I was so young. Way back then, we had something called the segment addition postulate. That's the one that let me take two segments and stick them end to end and then add their measures and tell you what the entire thing was. You remember doing that? Yeah? Some of you do, some of you don't. We also did it with angles, where I stuck two angles next to each other, this angle here and this angle here, and I added the measure of this angle, and I added it to the measure of this angle, and it gave me the measure of the entire big angle, the angle addition postulate. You remember doing stuff like that? We have one exactly the same, but for arcs. What do you think that one's called? Random guess. We have segment addition postulate where you add segments together. You have angle addition postulate where you add angles together. And now we're going to be talking about adding arcs together. You didn't hear it because he mouthed it real quiet. He said arc addition postulates. The arc addition postulate is the postulate that allows me to sum the measures of two arcs that are stuck next to each other to get the measure of a larger one. One last property, and that is the measure of a semicircle. What is a semicircle? Yeah, half a circle. A full circle is 360. Semicircle is half a circle. So a semicircle is 180 degrees. Good. When you're ready, turn the page. Let's do a few examples on the back. And we'll stop when you guys are feeling comfortable with it. All right, I'm gonna redraw the figure here just so that I can zoom in, but this figure is this one over here, okay? You do not have to redraw the figure. You can use the figure over here on the right. I am redrawing it so that way I can zoom in and y'all can see what I'm doing. Okay. So the directions say, line segment BD and AC are diameters. Identify each of these as either a major arc, a minor arc, or a semicircle, and then find its measure. All right. The first one is arc ABA. Start at B, go toward A, take the shortest distance. That's the arc I'm looking at. It's a minor arc. How do you know it's a minor arc? Because my central angle creating it is 44 degrees, that's much less than half of a circle, which is 180 degrees, making this thing a minor arc. And you can see it's like tiny, right? The measure of arc BC. Start at B, go towards C, take the shortest way possible. Major arc or minor arc?
Major arc.
It definitely looks bigger than the original, but is it larger than half the circle? No, it's a minor arc. It doesn't matter how big it is, as long as we can see clearly that it is smaller than half the circle. It measures less than 180. So now the question is, what is its measure? This is a diameter. We were given that at the beginning, which means this entire thing is a semicircle. So take the measure of your semicircle, subtract off the piece that you don't want, and that is the measure of that arc, which is, use a calculator.
136.
Speaking of semicircles, let's go ahead and identify one since we used one. What was the semicircle you used here? It started at A, it ended at C, and it went through which point? So our name is going to be arc A, B, C. And its measure is 180. That little M in front means measure. So I just rewrote the name of the thing and I put an M in front for measure of. All right, let's do the last one. The last one is ACB. Start at A. I need a different marker because you can't see that. Okay, let's use this black pen. Start at A, end at B, but go through C, which means I can't go this way because I'll get to B before I get to C. So I have to go this way. This is the arc that I'm talking about. Is it a major arc or a minor arc?
Major.
Definitely major. I went more than halfway around that circle. Totally a major arc. What's its measure? We can just subtract 44 from 360. That would totally get us the answer. It's not the only way to do it. Did you see how I went through a semicircle and then went more? I could, if I wanted to, grab the measure of that semicircle and added to it however further I went. Both of these are correct ways to get the measure of this major arc. Does it matter which one you use? No, it does not. Use whichever is easiest for you. Okay? Now we've been talking about going around the circle and I've been equating it to distance, like physically walking around this circle. But we've just been doing it in terms of angle measures. I want to know how far would I actually be walking? Well, that depends on the radius of the circle, how big my circle is. If my circle were small, like the size of maybe my trash can, I wouldn't have to walk very far to walk around the trash can, as opposed to, say, a circle that's drawn out in the middle of the football field. That would be a much bigger circle. And I wouldn't want to walk that because it's a very long way to walk. And so the length of distance you walk in these arcs depends on how big the circle is, its radius. And that gives us the next two equations. Before we get into these equations, I would like to give you some variables, some symbols that we're going to be using. That is a cursive L, which you'll see me write this way. It's a cursive L, and we're going to use this cursive L to represent the arc length. That is the actual physical distance you were walking around the outside of the circle, whether it's the size of my trash can or some big circle that we draw out on the football field. Okay? You're also going to see this symbol, which we are going to use to represent our angle measure. And that was these measurements that we were playing with before. And the last symbol that you'll see, you saw yesterday, R for radius. Yes, it's supposed to be a lowercase r. I'm really bad at drawing lowercase r's in prints. So I write them as capital R's, just small. Sorry. Here's our first formula. The arc length, that is the distance you physically walk around the circle from one point to another, is equal to whatever I get when I take the angle measure that I'm sweeping through divided by the total number of degrees in my circle, 360. And I multiply that, whatever I get after that division, by the circumference of the circle. Which means I have really two formulas. One where circumference is written as 2 times pi times the radius, and then another one where the circumference is written as pi times the diameter. No one cares which one you use, whichever helps you in the moment. Okay? Let's practice this one before I get into the very last item, which is talking about this last formula for angle measure. Okay? Okay. So let's look at 15 and 16. I'm going to redraw the figure here for 15. So 15's figure looks like this. You do not have to draw the figure. It's for you, it's printed for you on the right side of your paper. I'm redrawing it because it's too far away and you can't see it if I zoom out. Okay, so I have a figure that looks like this, and I'm trying to find the measurement, the length of arc DE. And I'm told that the radius is 2 meters. My formula says the arc length is the measure of the angle divided by 360 times the circumference of the circle. Was I given radius or diameter?
Radius.
Radius. So I'm going to choose 2 times pi times the radius as my formula for circumference in this arc length formula. Okay? Just to make my life easier. One less thing to do. All right, I'm going to substitute. Here is the measure of my angle. Here is the length of my radius. I'm just going to plug in the information I was given. Measure central angle divided by 360 times 2 times pi times the radius, which is 2. And if you have your TI Inspires out in front of you, you can literally type that. Exactly the way you see it, and it will spit out a number at you. So I would like you at this time, if you have one of the TI Inspires, please type just this piece here at the end, exactly the way you see it. And if you don't have a TI Inspire, you can go grab one real quick so you can type this in. And I would very much like you to practice typing it in so you can find the pi button.
It's located at the bottom by the letter H.
And round it to the nearest hundredth. So 2 decimal places, please.
4.18.
What comes after the 8?
8.
Another 8. So I need to round this to 4.19 because I was asked to take it to the nearest hundredth. And so I only want 2 decimal places. Okay? Yes?
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to do 16. So while you're finishing that up, I'm going to redraw my figure to get it ready for 16.
So that was the answer?
That's it. That's the answer. We done, dude. All right. Number 16. Number 16 is asking that we find the length of arc DEA. Start at D, go through E, stop at A. Find the length of that arc given that the diameter is 7 inches. It's using the same formula. So the arc length equals the central angle measure divided by 360 times the circumference of the circle. But was I given radius or diameter? Which means I want to use the formula for circumference of a circle that uses diameter. Okay? It's the same formula. I'm just using a different formula for circumference in it. All right. We're going to substitute what I know. What is the measure of the central angle creating this arc? Well, I have this piece at 120, but I have this piece at... This piece is 120, but this piece is 90. So it's 120 plus 90, which is 210. Okay. Yeah, I believe you. I don't know. Grab the calculator. Double check it. You just blurt it out. That's okay. Grab a calculator. Double check it.
It's pi before 7.
And it's, well, I'm doing it in the same order as my formula.
Oh.
Yeah. So you could write times 7 pi. I'm just,
yeah. Can I put that in your calculator?
Yep, and then you put this part in your calculator. So was it 210?
Yes.
Okay. Again, round it to the nearest hundredth. So you're going to look at the second decimal place, then the one right after it, and go, is that number 5 or bigger? If it's 5 or bigger, you're going to add 1 to the one that you were looking at.
8, 2, 8.
I want to round to here.
3.
The number after that is bigger than 4,
mm-hmm.
And so I'm going to round up. That's it. Easy enough? Let me hook you up for pre-calc. Sorry. Let me hook you up for pre-cal. Get you ready for a topic that comes up a lot in pre-calculus. And it's something that you saw in your calculators. In your calculators, these things are set to degree mode. Okay? Right here. Yes? They're set to degree mode. We had talked about making sure that they were always in degree mode because if you didn't, answers got weird, especially in trig. And that's because of this. We can set angles, oh goodness. We can set angles to be in something called radian. So the option there above degree? Radian. Let me talk to you about what radian is. Because I remember when we did that, I was like, don't worry about it. We'll talk about it later. It's now later. So if I look at this picture, I see that I have some circle with some radius. If I were to walk along this circle and walk the same amount of distance as I would walk if I were just walking a radius, the angle that I have just swept along that circle is 1 radian. This angle measure is 1 radian. Radian tells you how far along the circle you should move if you take the radius of the circle and you wrap it around the circle. Okay? So this distance and this distance and this distance are all the same. Almost like an equilateral triangle, but one of the sides is a curve. Okay? So all those distances are the same. That angle in there is a radian. And it gives you this formula. The angle measure in radians is equal to whatever the arc length is divided by the radius of the circle And your units of measure are radian. Like the other angle measures are degree. Like we can measure how tall I am in feet. Can measure how much I weigh in pounds. We won't talk about how much that is. It's way too much. When we measure how far we move along the circle, if we measure angle measures like this as a ratio of arc length to radius, our unit measure is radian. Okay? You'll play with that more in pre-cal. But you're welcome. We started it now. You're introduced to it. That's it. Thank you.